Yo, 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 what is going on, everybody? It's the Real Kaaayle here, back with some Mortal Kombat 11 content. Just overall content to the channel. And, you know, it's Sunday, everybody. Happy Sunday to everybody. Hope you guys had a good weekend. And you know what I do on Sundays? I like to do a little bit more discussion rather than play the game itself. So today, as you can tell by the title, we're going to be talking about the future of Mortal Kombat 11. The future of NRS going into the year of 2020. So just a disclaimer before I really get into this video is mostly going to be about speculation, all right? It's mostly speculation. There's nothing that I'm basing this off of. I'm basing this off of pretty much the past, pretty much things that has happened in 2011 up until now with NRS Studios. So that's what I'm basing it off of. Don't think there's any leaks. Nothing in this video that I will talk about will be 100% concrete unless like something else specifically that I talk about is concrete, but most of it is just speculation. So don't go around thinking that there's leaks, looking for rumors, or spreading, you know, what I'm saying as gospel, because it's not. I don't have an insider. I am just completely speculating, because speculating is fun, let's be real. Like, just thinking about the future and making predictions and seeing if it comes true, that's pretty fun. I like doing stuff like that. So as you guys may have known, Ed Boon posted a tweet earlier in 2019 saying that MK11 will be supported longer than any NRS fighting game that they've done for a while. So this leads me to believe that there's going to be a lot more stuff coming to Mortal Kombat 11, seeing as how popular the game is. The game is still alive and kicking. The pro scene is still very, very active, and people overall just really, really enjoy the game, and there's a lot more stuff coming earlier 2020. So let's just begin with things that we know for sure that are coming to Mortal Kombat 11. So later this month, we're gonna have the Joker in Mortal Kombat 11. Joker is releasing on, I believe, January 26th. Let me just make sure of that. Let me just real quick. January 28th. He's launching on January 28th, so the end of this month. So that gives us 2 weeks from today, Joker will be at MK11. So based off of that, I definitely do think we could possibly have a trailer, like a gameplay trailer with Joker, like how they do like the visionettes for all the characters, showing, you know, the special moves, all the different moves they can do, the fatal blow and the fatality for Joker. We could possibly have that sometime this week. And then the following week, they'll do a combat cast of the Joker, like around Wednesday or Thursday. And then the next following week, he'll be out. So don't be surprised, guys. I think we might get a Joker trailer this week, if not next week. But the Joker gameplay trailer is coming soon, for sure. And then later this year, we're going to have the last DLC character of Combat Pack 1, and that is Spawn. I believe Spawn is supposed to release sometime in March. I don't know the date specifically. Let me just Google the date really quick. March 26 is when Spawn is going to be coming out. So two more DLC characters in the span of 3 months. That's pretty insane. And he'll be releasing April 2nd for everybody else, but Combat Pack owners, we get about April 26th. So pretty much a year anniversary, Spawn will come out. So that's what we know for a fact is in the pipeline for MK11. Now, I think we know that this is coming, guys. The next thing I'm going to talk about, and we know that for sure, is coming for MK11. We just don't have an ETA or update. There's probably going to be another balance patch for MK11. Not necessarily the last one, but I think there's going to be a balance patch, shuffling up the tier list again, nerfing and buffing said characters. That's something, balance patches are always exciting. It's always nice to see how the game alters and how the meta shifts from tier lists. And yeah, the game for the most part is pretty good right now, but in order to keep the game like fresh and kind of, you know, moving and progressing, NRS will most likely release a balance patch in between the releases of Joker and Spawn, for sure. So now, we're going to get into the speculation part of the video, and we're going to start talking about the possibility of a Combat Pack 2. So, Injustice 2 did not have another season, pretty much. They just had the 3 combat packs, 9 DLC characters, technically if you count Darkseid. But it was released 1 month after each other. So pretty much once Injustice 2 came out, the next DLC character came out in June, and then every month we had a DLC character in Injustice. It was exciting. That's why that game always felt fresh and new, but let's be real. The game died out pretty quickly because of the patches. Like, honestly, the game was pretty balanced towards the end of its life cycle. And with once all the DLC came out, there was really nothing left for Injustice. Like, Injustice was done by, like, around March. So the game only had, like, a 9-month life cycle, right? And so Combat Pack 2. So before we get into all that, I'm kind of jumping all over the place, but Combat Pack 2, I definitely do think it's very possible for this game. If NRS actually wants to support this game for a very long time, up until like their next release, pretty much they want to keep this game alive for until the next release, they need to release a second Combat Pack, right? There's no telling when this second Combat Pack is going to be, because correct me if I'm wrong, the MKX Combat Pack, let me just search this up really quick. MKX released in 2015. So the second Combat Pack of MKX came out March 1st of 2016. So based off the fact that Joker and Spawn are coming earlier this year, there's possibly we're not going to get Combat Pack 2. I personally think we're probably not going to get a Combat Pack 2 until like the fall, maybe, for Mortal Kombat 11, the fall or the summertime. So unless if they probably have been working on Combat Pack 2 in between Joker and Spawn, but I'm just thinking that based on the fact that NRS also said that they didn't want to overwork their staff and their employees, because remember there was this that little bit of controversy that they had when MK11 released, with certain employees saying that the way they pump out the content, they do a lot of crunch time, they have a lot of long hours and testing periods and just long, like, pretty grueling crunch periods. They kind of wanted to change the work environment at NRS Studios, which goes into the reason why I think the DLC is so spread out in this game. So, realistically speaking, I think if their Combat Pack 2 is coming out for Mortal Kombat 11, it will most likely be, I would say, mid-late summer or fall, the fall period. So, who I think is going to be in that Combat Pack, that's a discussion for a whole other video. There's so many characters that they can go with in Combat Pack 2. But, I don't know. It depends. It really just depends how much they want to listen to fans. But I'm going to open that can of worms on another video for sure. But my speculation is if they're going to do another Combat Pack 2, it will most likely be the summertime or fall time for sure. And we're not going to hear anything about a Combat Pack 2 until a little bit after Spawn comes out. Like, so Spawn is coming out March 26th. We're not going to hear about a Combat Pack 2 probably until like April, and then it might actually release that fall. So the fall. So this brings me to my next big speculation, is NRS's next fighting game. And it's kind of crazy to really start thinking about this, but as NRS players, NRS fans, we've kind of gotten used to like this release cycle. They release a game every 2 years. They release a game every 2 years ever since MK9 has came out back in 2011. And the schedule still exists based on how MK11 was released. So let's talk about it. 2011, MK9. 2013 was Injustice 1. 2015, MKX. 2017, Injustice 2. Now 2019, MK11. Every 2 years there is a game. So by the time the first year is up for NRS fighting game, the community is already thinking about their next launch, and they have the pattern of a Mortal Kombat game than an Injustice game right now. So, based on the schedule, it's 2020 right now. The next fighting game that NRS will put out will most likely be the third Injustice game. The third Injustice game will most likely be released in April, I would say between the months of April and May of 2021. Now, it's just really a matter of when is that reveal going to happen? And I think this is where things get a little bit more complicated and a little bit not less hazy, because MK11, they revealed the game extremely late. So I remember around E3 time, everybody was talking about, yo, NRS is going to reveal the new Mortal Kombat E3. E3 came around, NRS did not even show up at E3. They were not at E3. There was no Mortal Kombat. So during this time, I remember, you know, the community was just very disappointed and just kind of gutted. It was like, wow, we're probably going to wait a whole nother year for another new NRS fighting game. Like, we're going to be playing Injustice 2 for so long. And by that time, most people already moved on from Injustice. I remember a lot of people were on Tekken, a lot of people were on Dragon Ball Fighters, different fighting games, pretty much. So, and I remember tweets from Ed Boon saying that, yeah, they're working on their next project, but this one, they're really, like, working hard on it. They're honing in on it, but they just want to make sure it's right. And when it's ready to be revealed, it's ready to be revealed. Then fast forward to winter, around December time of 2018, MK11 was revealed at the Game Awards. And even the release date was revealed for MK11. The release date was in April. So, MK11 was revealed about 6 months before the game actually came out, which was pretty insane. I remember that reveal. I was like, really? So the schedule of release for the game was the same. They just revealed it later. I guess they just wanted the hype. They just wanted once the game was revealed, you didn't have to wait so long to get your hands on it, which I thought was brilliant. I thought the hype period for MK11 was amazing. The marketing, the promo, the streams, just the social media presence around Mortal Kombat 11 was amazing. That's how you promote a video game, a fighting game too, a fighting game with such a big legacy. And it worked, because MK11, when it came out, it was actually the highest selling game of the year. And the game came out late April. Pretty darn good. The only game that beat it was 2K, and 2K came out in September, so it was on top. Mortal Kombat 11 was the highest selling game from 2019 for a very long time. So there's another thing that brings into a lot of speculation now. So this fall, we're also going to be getting the next generation systems. So not only does that mean that this, whatever NRS's next title is coming out, will most likely launch in 2021, but it'll also be on the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X. And I think that is exciting to behold. Like, we're going to be having NRS's first fighting game, like, early in the new console generation. And it most likely will be Injustice 3, just based off of the schedule. And I know some people are like, oh, they're kind of put off by Injustice because of its gameplay. I think Injustice is a perfect game to launch on the new systems, because the DC fan base, I think superhero movies and superhero content is more popular than before. Look at the Hollywood, like the highest selling movies, the most popular, most talked about movies right now are honestly superhero movies, regardless if it's Marvel or DC. Joker made a lot of money, and Joker's in MK11. Like, come on, like, it has to be Injustice 3, guys. It's gonna be Injustice 3. It's gonna be awesome. And I think they're gonna kind of take steps to overhaul Injustice's gameplay, like how they did with MKX to MK11. I remember one of the reasons why MK11 is so different gameplay wise from X is just that NRS said that they felt MKX and 9 played a bit too similar. They wanted to go somewhere different, take the series somewhere different. And Justice 2 was kind of a very legacy-like game. A lot of the combos that you could have done in Injustice 1 worked in Injustice 2. And it felt very similar. There was like obviously like little mechanics around the game that made it felt different, and the look of the game. But the games are pretty similar, so I expect the same kind of gameplay overhaul from Injustice 2 going into Injustice 3. And I think if they speed up the gameplay, they speed up, they do something about the projectiles and the roster, like, I just think it's just gonna be amazing, especially with next generation technology. The graphics are going to look phenomenal. The game is going to look amazing. Just seeing what NRS can do with MK11 on PS4, Xbox One right now, imagine what they can do on a next generation system. The game is just gonna look godlike. It's gonna run amazing. The online's gonna be fantastic, and it's just gonna be amazing. So my prediction for when Injustice 3 will get revealed, they could definitely do it this year E3. This year's E3 is going to be pretty huge because of the next generation systems. I think a lot of companies, a lot of different developers are going to be at this year's E3. It's going to be a big point of the industry because of the consoles that we have right now, they're becoming outdated. New systems, new hardware is coming out. So we could predict E3 of this year. But because NRS waited to the Game Awards for December, I would say anytime from E3 up until the end of 2020, we can hear the reveal for Injustice 3. So it could be at PAX, it could be at the Game Awards again, it could be at Gamescom. Honestly, at this point, I feel like NRS, they could, anything can happen, really. So we really have to just keep our ears to the streets and just be on the lookout, because there's some pretty exciting times for NRS and, you know, Mortal Kombat and fighting games in general. So that's gonna be it for today, y'all. Let me know what you guys think. Are you guys excited for the future of Mortal Kombat 11, the future of NRS? And I'm really excited, because as much as I love MK11, I'm at this point, because of this 2-year cycle, I'm already thinking towards the future. That's why this whole video is being made. So I just would like some new content. I think Injustice 3 would be so good to see on next generation systems. I really enjoyed Injustice 2. I love superhero content. So that's going to be a big thing for me. When, best believe, if the next game is Injustice 3, whatever the next game will be, Mortal Kombat or Injustice, it will be featured on this channel heavily. So let me know what you guys think. What are your predictions? Maybe the next video I'll do my predictions on who I think will be in Combat Pack 2. So stay tuned for the channel. Keep your ears to the streets. Stay real, y'all. Have a good day. Peace.